fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am. I need to know. Whoa, you say I am loved when I can't feel a thing. You say I am strong when I think I am weak. You say I am held when I am falling short. And when you say of me, the only thing that matters now is everything you think of me. In you I find my worth, in you I find my identity. Oh, every victory, 'cause you say I am loved.
My rest is told. Yet in my dreams the pain nearer, my God, to thee, nearer to thee, nearer to thee. There let the way appear, steps up to sendest me in mercy give. Angels to call me nearer, my God, to thee,
nearer, my God, to thee,
nearer to thee. My waking thoughts bright with thy praise, out of my stony graves Bethel I raise. So by my woes to be nearer, my God, zu dir mehre, mein Gott zu dir mehre, zu dir.
Amen. God is good. And all the time. Happy, happy Sabbath.
Happy, happy day.
We are welcomed once again to today's service. It's time for our prayers, and let's begin our prayers with hymn 478.
Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer,
that calls me from a world of care, and bids me at my Father's throne, make home.
Hello.
Our seats. Today's prayer session we are basing on Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 to 7. I'm reading from the NIV Bible. The Bible says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen."
Amen.
So this is a season to bring out all that we have in our hearts. And we are sure that God is here to listen to us. Amen. Amen. I would like to invite three people up front to take this prayer set for us. As touched by the Spirit. Thank you. The first person is praying to thank God and also to ask for forgiveness of sins, and then to ask for the Holy Spirit outpouring on each and every one of us here. The second person is praying for the church administration, right from the general conference president to all departments, seeking for God's direction and insight to lead his church. The third person is praying for all church projects. We know all that the church is doing, so we ask God to lead us through all the church projects and also for unity among church members. Let's sing the first verse of the hymn we just sang, Sweet Hour of Prayer.
Shall we all be on our feet, please?
Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, that calls me from the world of care and bids me at my Father's throne, make all my wants and wishes known. In sins is all distress and grief, my soul. Sweet hour of prayer.
Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the life you've given us. We thank you so much for the protection you've given us. We thank you so much that throughout this weather, the snow, you brought us into this sanctuary safely. We say, may your name be praised.
Amen.
Father, we are grateful that you are always there for us. Father, we are grateful that you are always protecting us. Father, we go to work, you bring us back. You know, people go to work and they don't return. We go to the grocery, you bring us back. People go there and they don't return. People go to school, they don't return. But we went to school, you brought us back home.
Yes.
Father, we say thank you.
Amen.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
For all the things that you do for us. We can't give the thanks to anybody else, but to you alone. And I always take this moment to pause a little bit, to think about it, that for somebody that does so much for us, why should we offend you? Why should we sin against you? Why should we do things that does not please you? We are sinners.
Yes.
We are born in sin. But by your grace and your mercy, you cleanse us. And so, Father, forgive us.
Amen.
For everything we did this week.
Yes.
That did not please you. Things we said that did not please you.
Yes.
Things we watched that did not please you.
Yes.
Places we went that did not please you.
Yes.
And how our tongue offended you this week. Father, yes. Please forgive us.
Amen.
Each and every one of us here today, we are in this sanctuary today because we need cleansing.
Yes.
And we pray that your Holy Spirit would descend upon us.
Yes.
Cleanse us and give us a new week when we walk out of here, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Father Divine, we thank you once again for this special moment for us to come before you, to worship you, and also to bring our prayer request before you. At this moment, we want to commit our administrators into your hand. To be specific, we want to commit the pastors of this church, Columbus Ghanaian. Father, we pray that you continue to give them wisdom and knowledge to lead the children and the members of this church. I pray for the church board of this church that any time they meet and start to plan, that you, Lord, will lead them. Mm-hmm. Father, I pray for our conference executives that you continue to shower your Holy Spirit to be with them so that all their plans and goals for the conference will be the one that will glorify your name. We pray for our general conference executive, the president, and all those who plan for this church, that you, Lord, will continue to direct them towards the way you want them to be. Amen. This is our humble prayer. In Jesus' mighty name have I prayed. Amen.
Amen. We want to continue to give you all the praise because you deserve it.
Yes.
Columbus Ghanaian is so much thankful for how far you have brought us.
Yes.
Your church has been doing a lot locally and overseas. We believe and trust that it is because you gave it to us. That's why we are also doing those things.
Yes.
And so we want to take opportunity to ask for your blessings.
Amen.
May you stretch forth your hand upon all the membership of this church. May you continue to bless our works.
Yes.
Those who are schooling, may you give us the wisdom to be able to be successful in our education.
Yes.
Dear Lord and Master Jesus, all the projects this church is undertaking, we want to commit it unto you.
Amen.
Resources come from you and you alone.
Yes.
And so may you give it to us.
Amen.
So that we'll be able to execute anything the church wants to do or are doing, so that it will be successful. We want to commit our social media platforms unto you.
Yes.
Every week we broadcast Sabbath School. It's been a blessing for others. Mm. We also transmit our worship. If there is anything your church lacks, and I ask him for, so that it will better place us in a position so that we'll be able to share your word across the group.
Yes.
May you grant it to us.
Amen.
Continue to be with your people.
Yes.
Let our worship be a blessing unto others. Mm. So that together we will meet you one day. We thank you for this privilege of worship this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let's rise and stand in groups of four as we take the next session of prayers in groups of four. In groups of four. So the first person is praying for all married couples, those praying for the fruit of the womb, those praying for peace at home. Anything that we think married couples need, let the first person pray for them. The second person is praying for all singles. Some of them need life partners, so let's commit the singles into God's care. The third person will pray for the youth and students, for God to guide their path and also to give them knowledge as they go to school. And the last person will pray for kids, the very little ones, that God guides them and protects them in school and wherever they go. Amen. I hope we got all the points.
days are filled with sorrow and care. Hearts are lonely and dread. But in so little that calvary, Jesus is very near. But in so little that calvary, 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 but in so little that calvary, Jesus is very near.
Mr. Doe, please come take this prayer point for us. So you pray committing all those in search of documentation, whether jobs, stay here, and all other forms of documentation, and also commit those in emotional, psychological, and physical problems to God. Shall we rise and pray?
Let's pray. Spirit of the living God, again, we are grateful for who you are. We are thankful that you're a good Lord who answers our prayers in spite of all our sinful activities. You're a good God because your grace is sufficient and is abundant upon us. And Lord Jesus, your grace is not predicated on how well we worship you. In spite of that, Lord, you still love us. And so, Lord, we do not take that for granted. We are grateful for that. Mm-hmm. Lord, at this very moment, we want to intercede and pray for people looking for documentations, people looking for ways to be able to make their documentations arrive to stay in this country. Lord Jesus, it's so difficult to be in this country without the right documents, even looking for jobs, promotions, or even doing major purchases. It's almost impossible. And so, Lord, it comes with frustrations and makes people, some of them even abandon the faith, and it leads people to do more complicated things. Lord Jesus, at this very moment, we are praying for all such people in our midst, whether they are watching at home or they are in the sanctuary or they are in the tree service. We are praying that in the name of Jesus, have mercy upon us. Help us and make our documents right. In the name of Jesus, if some of us have filed and are waiting for responses, at this very moment, I pray that wherever our documents are stuck up, Lord Jesus, you shall open doors for our documents to come through. I pray that if our documents need somebody to certify or somebody to approve, in the name of Jesus, wherever it may be, Jesus, you shall shine your countenance upon it. And Lord Jesus, our documents will go through successfully. Lord, you did it for some of us, and I know you continue to do it because you are in the miracle working business. Lord Jesus, there are even people who do not know where to turn to. They do not even have the funds to consult an attorney or anything. But Lord Jesus, they have you. And Lord, as we are praying at this very moment, please answer our prayers accordingly. Some of them have also found themselves in emotional quagmires, difficult situations, and are emotionally and psychologically drained. At this very moment, I pray that, Lord Jesus, if there be any such people in our midst who are falling into all forms of depression, all forms of mental health issue, Jesus, have mercy upon them. You are the great physician. So, Lord Jesus, I pray you shall visit such individuals and speak hope into their hearts. You shall speak hope into them. And, Lord Jesus, you shall make the impossible possible, because in your sight, impossibility does not exist. There are also some of us who are looking for jobs with the right documentation, but we just can't seem to find the right job. Lord Jesus, There is nothing beyond you. So, Lord Jesus, if there are people in our midst, as they are tendering in their applications, as their resumes are going to HR and the recruiters, Lord Jesus, I pray that you shall shower them with divine favor. I pray that as recruiters and HR people see their name, Lord Jesus, divine favor would follow them. And they will be able to be called to the job interviews. And when they go for interviews, you shall help them to be able to get these jobs. And Lord Jesus, when you have done all these things for us, we would be minded that, Lord, we shall come back to give glory to your name. And we shall not take the credit because it wasn't our doing, but it was the doing of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for being a good God, and thank you for being a prayer-answering Father. Because in faith, we have prayed, and we believe that our prayers have been answered. Amen.
Amen. Let's be seated. I would like to leave us with this from 1 John chapter 5, verse 14. It reads, "This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. Amen."
Happy Sabbath, everyone. Happy Sabbath. We thank God for his protection, that even through all the snow, that we're still alive, and we have not been in any car accidents or anything of that sort. And today, we're also able to worship at his feet. Amen. It is time for announcements, so let us listen to our announcements for today. So for our Thanksgiving, we have quite a few number of people that have been celebrating their birthdays or celebrated their birthdays this past week. The first one is Dr. Osei and Auntie Mavis are thanking God for the life of Nyametiase. He turned one last week, so happy belated birthday. Mr. Owusu Asamoah and family are also thanking God for adding another year to their son Samuel's age. He turned 17 on Sunday, so happy belated birthday to you as well, Samuel. And our sister, Rita Koko, is also thanking God for adding another year to her age. So happy belated birthday to our sister, Rita, as well. It is our prayer that God continues to see you guys through each stage and each walk of your life with him. This Thanksgiving is coming from Miss Bella and family. So they're thanking God as well as the church for helping them out during their funeral service of her late mother. And they're actually here today at the tree service to give thanks to God. So let us continue to keep the family in prayer during this time. This is for our midweek Wednesday prayer sessions. So we officially resumed this this past Wednesday. It's from 7 to 8 p.m. on our Zoom platform. So please do so to tune in when you have the chance. So just a reminder that we have officially resumed our Wednesday prayer sessions on Zoom. As we all know, this month of February, we had the theme, Love Matters. So we're going to continue today's event with this theme. And the topic is Fall in Love and Stay in Love. And we are very privileged to have our own pastor that is going to be leading us through this topic as well. So let us all please tune in for this as well and take it with an open heart. As we're talking about our theme for this month, I cannot also leave without talking about our formal dinner. So I know we've made so many announcements about this dinner, but it is finally here and it will be happening tonight at 7 p.m. So for those of us that were able to pay, it will be at 7 p.m. Please try to be on time so that we can be able to maximize the program as well as the space that we have at the event. The location is Embassy Suites by Hilton Columbus, and the address is 2700 Corporate Exchange Drive. It's on the flyer that's in the WhatsApp group chat for those that want to also view it. The dress code is formal, So we're asking for everyone to be formal, but also let's try to be modest as possible. And this is a reminder that we should have a touch of red in our outfit. So somewhere in our looks, we should have that touch of red as well. And we will also be having a special guest, Mr. and Mrs. Hansen, that will be joining us to lead us in a program during that dinner. So the dinner is ready. It's just us. We need to bring our beautiful selves and dress up for that dinner. I looked at the menu, and the menu is beautiful, amen? So let us all come on time so we are able to maximize that as well. This reminder is going for the membership list. This is a reminder that it's still out on the bulletin board. So for anyone that your information is incorrect or needs to be updated, please do so for the secretarial team. This announcement is coming from the Call to Worship team. So they're letting us know that the Bible that they use for the Call to Worship is missing. So if anyone has seen this, please let the team know as they are looking for that as well. Men's Ministry is having a breakfast next Sabbath, February 24th at 7:30 a.m. They're inviting all the men as well as the youth to attend this program as well. So for all the men and the youth in this church, next Sabbath at 7:30 p.m., there will be a men's ministry breakfast. Women's Ministry is also reminding us that they meet every Tuesday on Zoom at 8 p.m. So for those interested in the topics, they meet every Tuesday at 8 p.m. And they'll also be meeting after church today at the tree service. So for anyone involved in Women's Ministry, after service, there is going to be a meeting. For church board members, there will also be a meeting next Sabbath after church at the tree service. So all board members, please take note of this as well. This announcement is coming from the Pathfinder leadership. There will be a meeting tomorrow at 12 p.m. at the tree service, the fellowship hall. So every Pathfinder that's here, no one is excluded. There will be a meeting tomorrow at 12 p.m. And our final announcement is coming from the NASDA team. I've been promoting CYP for a while now. So this is a reminder that registration is officially open, and the date is March 28th to the 31st. It will be a Thursday through Sunday, and the location is in Chicago. So if you want any more updates or any more questions that you have, you can visit the website cyp.nasda.org for more information on that. Today's Love Nugget, we will get it from Pastor Bimbo, and it reads, the title is What Every Woman Wants. A woman wants a man who can take charge. She wants a man who is the superintendent in the home, a provider for the family, and a dad for her kids. She wants someone who can take responsibility for his actions, a real man who is dependent and trustworthy. She wants her husband to be the priest, prophet, and king at all times. She doesn't want a man who is married to his job, who is too tired to do anything when he gets home. Women feel loved and appreciated when their husbands spend quality time with them. Women want men who will be committed to them forever, men who won't commit adultery, and men who can be trusted with other women. Amen. At this time, I'll call upon Pastor Jay to pray for those that celebrated their birthdays today or within this week.
Amen. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
I'm
very happy to see you in spite of the snow. This shows that we are serious for God, you know. One time, one guy was telling me he won't come to church because he's tired, but he has the strength to go to work. And I said, man, you are not being fair to God. So if you are here, God bless you for coming. So at this moment, I would like to call Nyame Tiase's mom to bring Nyame Tiase. And also, is Samuel here? Samuel is also celebrating his birthday. If he's here, he can also come up front. Let me re-emphasize the dinner again. It's coming up. It's coming up. It's not canceled. It's not canceled. Those of you who are not aware, it's coming up this evening. By the way, there will be no afternoon program today because we want you guys to go take time and get ready, you know. Hannah, I hope you hear me, right? Go home, get ready. So the afternoon program has been shifted to the dinner. We're going to study about love language. Man, you need to know this. There are love language. If you don't know it, you'll be wasting your time. Yes, you need to know it. So let's all meet there. It's Nyamitiase. Please, can you bring Nyamitiase as we pray? Samuel, yes, you're also celebrating your birthday. Come as I pray for you. Can we all be on our feet? Can we all be on our feet? Happy birthday to you guys. You too?
Yeah.
Oh, happy birthday. Happy birthday. Nyamitiase, happy birthday. Samuel, happy birthday. Let's pray. Father, we thank you so much for bringing these wonderful people to this planet Earth. I know their life on this earth is not an accident. You plan for them, and you have a purpose for each one of them. So as we are remembering this day of their birth, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that you, Lord, will continue to direct their lives so that they can fulfill their mission and their purpose on this planet Earth. Father, I ask for more blessings. I ask for more life, long years with good health for all these wonderful people. This is our humble prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus have I prayed. Amen.
Amen.
Happy birthday.
Happy Sabbath, everyone.
Happy day.
Happy Sabbath, everyone.
Happy day.
Happy Love Month to each and every one of y'all. Y'all look good. Y'all smell good. I think it's the aroma of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. All right. Well, this is the praise team. My name is, those who don't know me, my name is Jeff Tarr. I am the worship leader here at the English service. Amen.
Amen.
And our team here, lovely people behind me, we're going to give y'all some worship, amen? And we're going to, we expect you guys to also worship with us because the worship is not for us, it's not for y'all, but it's for who? It's for the Lord, amen?
Amen.
So let's go ahead and stand up for the Lord, amen? We have this song that we haven't yet sung with y'all, but I'm pretty sure people may know it. It's called, I'm on the Lord's side, who can be against me? I'm on the Lord's side. Who can be against me? I will win again, and I will celebrate the victory. I will win again, and I will celebrate the victory. It's an easy song to catch on. So if you catch it, just sing along with us. feel free to lift up your voice, your parts, the altos, the sopranos, the tenors. I know. Amen.
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 I will never give.
side.
I am on the Lord's side. He's on my side. I will never give up on Him. I'm an overcomer. For the Lord God is on my side. I am on the Lord's side. He's on my side. I will never give up on Him. I'm an overcomer. For the Lord God is on my side.
On the Lord's side, I will never give up. I'm an overcomer. For the Lord God is on my side. On my side.
I am on the Lord's side. I will never give up. I'm an overcomer. For the Lord God is on my side.
Amen, amen. We are all on the Lord's side on this morning. The next song that we have for you all is called Crown Him. Crown Him by Joe Meadow. Very soft song. It goes like, we crown you, Lord, and we hail Him as King. It is His majesty that we ascribe to and that we sing about. So I hope you also enjoy this song as well. Even as we sing this song, just feel free to just think about the things that God has done for you and how wonderful He's been just throughout this month of February and how wonderful He is.
We crown you.
King.
Oh, hell
Song we'll be singing is, you'll find it in your hymnal, hymn 579, "'Tis Love That Makes Us Happy." "'Tis Love That Makes Us Happy."
To others every day. And when the judgment is over and we are taught above our song shall be eternally of Jesus and his love. God is love, we are his little children. God is love, we'll be like him. Just love that makes us happy. Just love that smooths away. It helps us mind, it makes us kind to others every day.
Happy Sabbath, church. Happy day. Today I'll be doing our call to worship. Our call to worship will be found in Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1 to 8. And it reads, there's an occasion for everything and every time for every activity underneath heaven, a time to give birth and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down, a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to throw stones and a time to gather stones. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth be silent before him.
The
hope in the coming of the Lord. Amen. Happy Sabbath. Happy, happy Sabbath. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I wanted to take time to read a psalm for us before we get started. I will be reading Psalms 113, and it reads, this is from the New King James Version. Praise the Lord. Praise all servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord from this time forth and forevermore. From the rising of the sun to its going down, the Lord's name is to be praised. The Lord is high above all nations, his glory above the heavens. Who is like the Lord our God? Who dwells on high, who humbles himself, behold, the things that are in heaven and in the earth. He raises the poor out of the dust and lifts the needy out of the ash heap, that he may seat him with princes, with the princes of his people. He grants the barren woman a home, like a joyful mother of children. Praise the Lord. Amen. I wanted to take time to introduce myself. I am Melanie Nibitanga. I will be your presider for today. And with me, there is our lovely Mrs. Patience Ajay. She will be doing stewardship. Amen. And then when the time is right, I will announce the one who will be giving us the word of God. I wanted to take time to acknowledge the guests that are in our midst. If you are worshiping with us for the very first time, please raise your hand so we can give you a big, loud amen. Amen! Welcome, sister. We hope to see you every Sabbath. I also wanted to take time to welcome each and every one of us here because, honestly, I don't know about you guys, I don't like the cold, and it took the Lord's grace for me to come out. So I am happy to see each and every one of you. You're all looking lovely. And let's say a big, loud amen for all of us. Amen. Amen. And then today's divine service is titled Falling in Love and Staying in Love. I hope we have all fallen in love with God and are staying in love with him. Amen. Amen. And then I will be calling our worship team for our opening hymn, SDA 652.
If we can all stand up as we sing our opening hymn, Love at Home.
You are the Holy One of Israel, the great I am, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. We come before you, God, this morning, praising you and worshiping your mighty name, God. We are here only because of you, because you loved us so much that you saw it fit that we take a breath this morning, that you saw it fit that we get up for the Lord. We are healthy and well because of you. We give all praise and thanksgiving to your mighty name. Father Lord, we pray for each and every person that is within our midst. If there's anyone, Father Lord, that is feeling inadequate, Father Lord, anyone that is feeling that there's not enough love within them, we pray that you may shower them with love. Remind them that you sent your one and only Son to die on the cross just for them. That, Father Lord, you take time, you think about them. The thoughts that you have for them outnumber the grains of sand on the beach. Father Lord, we thank you so very much that you have been so merciful. Your unfailing love endures forever, God, and we will praise you forevermore for that. Dear Heavenly Father, at this time, we call the Holy Spirit to come and dwell among us. Father Lord, we know that there are so many distractions, so many things that may take us away from the word that you have prepared for us. Father Lord, we come against all those things in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord and Savior. Whatever word you have for each and every individual here today, may they hearken unto your voice, Father Lord. May they open up their hearts to hear your word, and may your word lead us throughout this entire day and all the things that we have planned. We pray for the man that you will use to give us your word, Father Lord. We pray that you may speak through him, and everything that he says may not be his own words, but may it be your words, Father Lord. Thank you so very much that you will be with us throughout this entire seven-day program. We thank you very much that you are a loving God. We pray, Father Lord, that in the end, we will all join together in the second coming of Jesus Christ, praising your name.
Happy Sabbath. God is good and all the time. It is always a privilege to be at the feet of Christ than anywhere else in this world. You could have been anywhere, especially on this snow day. But if you are here safely and sound, then when I say God is good, you're going to respond better. Let's try this again. God is good, and all the time. Amazing, amazing, amazing. It is now time for our stewardship, and I'm going to read a short verse as we want to be fed on the word more today, so we will not take a lot of time. I'm going to read from Mark chapter 8, verses 36. Mark chapter 8, verse 36. Let's hear the word of God. For what does it profit a man to gain the whole world and forfeit his soul? For what can a man give in return for his soul? Amen. And when I think about this verse, I ask, what are you holding God's money for? What is it that is preventing you to give God's money to him? It's not yours. So what are you holding it for?
Now, is it going to make you richer? And if it does, can that richness give you eternal life? What will it profit you if you gain all the money in this world, including God's money, and lose your soul? It is something that I think about a lot and say, if it's not mine and I need to return his money and get blessing, why not, right? And so it is something I want us to think about. Is that money going to make you richer? And if it does, is it worth losing your soul? May the Lord help us on this Sabbath day to remain faithful in our giving. Amen. Let's call our ushers to take our offering and the music team to give us music.
Hello. You know that I'm gonna view that holy city. Oh, I'm gonna view that holy city one of these days. I'm gonna view that holy city. View that holy city one of these days. One of these days.
You know that I'm gonna meet my loving Jesus.
Oh, I'm gonna meet my loving Jesus one of these days. Jesus, one of these days, one of these days.
You know that I'm gonna sit at the welcome table.
Oh, I'm gonna sit at the welcome table one of these days.
Hallelujah,
I'm gonna sit at the welcome table.
I'm gonna
view that holy city, meet my loving Jesus. Sit at the welcome table one of these days, one of these days.
You know that I'm gonna feast on milk and honey.
Oh, I'm gonna feast on milk and honey one of these days.
Hallelujah,
I'm gonna feast on milk and honey.
I'm gonna view that holy city, meet my loving Jesus. Sit at the welcome table, feast on milk and honey one of these days, one of these days. You know that I'm gonna sing and never get tired.
Oh, I'm gonna sing and never get tired one of these days.
Hallelujah,
I'm gonna sing and never get tired.
I'm gonna view that holy city,
meet my loving Jesus. Sit at the welcome table, feast on milk and honey. Sing and never get tired, sing and never get tired. Sing and never get tired. Singing never get tired, singing never get tired. One of these days, one of these days, one of these days.
What do we say to them? We haven't heard you guys in a while. We haven't heard you guys in a while. We need to see you guys more often. Bring ye all the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house, says the Lord your God. Shall we pray? Our Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this privilege that we have today. And today, we don't think it's worth it to hold your money and lose our blessings and our soul. And so we brought our tithe and our offering from the bottom of our heart. Please accept it and bless us. Anyone that couldn't give, whatever it is they need,
able to give, Father, please give them. If it is job, Father, please give them. If it is anything that they will need in their day-to-day life, let today be the day they received their blessings. We thank you for hearing us in Jesus' name. Amen. Fall in love and stay in love. And today, our scripture reading that my husband will be preaching with will be taken from Proverbs chapter 30, verses 18 to 19. Proverbs chapter 30, verses 18 to 19. Let's hear the word of God. Three things are too wonderful to me. Four, I do not understand. An eagle flying in the sky. A snake moving on a rock. A ship finding its way over the sea. And a man and a woman falling in love. May the Lord bless his reading. In Jesus' name, amen. I'll leave the rest here for him to continue.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Just from the reading alone, you're excited. I wanted to take time to introduce the man that will be giving us that message, and it was our very own pastor, Samuel J. The first time I came to this church, actually a year ago this month, he was the one who was preaching, and I remember my first time here, I just walked out and left. I didn't even greet anyone. I just left. Then the second time I came back, it was like, you know, he was giving the message, and his wife came and introduced herself and introduced me to everyone else. But what I wanted to say is that he is a man of God, a true man of God. Not only that, he's a friend to each and every one of us. He takes time to get to know us, introduce himself to us, see what we need and how he can best support us and pray for us. And so we thank God for him, and we pray that God may continue to use him. And before he comes up and gives us our message, we have a special song from Mr. and Mrs. Hansen. May they come up here and give us a special song. Amen.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. Today we are talking about love. Yeah, it's one of those topics that causes the giggles. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, the love chapter. We know that one, you know. Charity suffereth long, and it's patient, it's kind. We know all of that. But the verse that just captures everything and ties it in together so well is the last verse that says, all of these things will last forever, faith, hope, and the charity or love. But the greatest of these is love. And as we minister this song this morning, we want to let you know that love will be your home. That's the aim.
Love is really where the heart is. Then home must be a place we all can share. And even with our differences, our hearts are much the same. And where love is, we come together there. Wherever there is laughter ringing, someone smiling, someone dreaming, we can live together there. Love will be your home. Wherever there are children singing, where a tender heart is beating, we can live together there. Love will be your home. With love, our hearts can be a family, and hope can bring this family face to face. And though we may be far apart, our hearts can be as one when love brings us together in one place. Wherever there is laughter ringing, someone smiling, someone dreaming, we can live together there. Love will be your home. Where there are words of kindness spoken, where a vow is never broken, we can live together there. Love will be your home. 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 Oh, love will be your home. Wherever there is laughter ringing, someone smiling, someone dreaming, we can live together there. Love will be your home. Love will be our home.
Amen. That was powerful. In case you're going to miss tonight's dinner, you're going to miss a lot. Because these wonderful couples are going to be there, and they are going to give us more than this. So get ready for this evening's dinner. And also, they are not just going to sing, they are also going to give us a very powerful presentation, which they are also going to talk from their own experience. So, Mr. and Mrs. Hansen, Kenya and Riffley, we thank you guys so much for the beautiful song. That's good. That's good. All right. I want to take this opportunity once again to welcome all of you. I also want to sincerely let you know that I really appreciate you guys for driving through the snow to be here today. I am very excited and happy that you are here. And if I, being a sinner, is excited that you are here, I believe God is more excited that you took the risk to be here. Amen. So throughout this month, those of you who are joining us for the first time, whether you are watching us through our social media platforms or you are here in person, throughout this month, we've been preaching and teaching about the theme, Love Matters, Love Matters. And the first week, we began with the first stage of love, which is dating and courtship. That was my message for the first week. So you can see these wonderful couples. They are all going to present. In fact, somebody came to me and said, we didn't see our picture on the flyer. And I said, it's just for the couples that are going to present. So if you are a couple and you didn't see yourself, please, it's not like I selected the best couples in the church. No, those who are going to present. All right, so I hope next year we're going to get different couples to present. And last week, if you guys remember, Pastor Chubesi came here and he gave us very important message about marriage, the meaning of marriage. And I love the afternoon presentation because that was when I was here. What is in marriage? You know, some of you might say, Pastor, I am not ready. I don't even have a girlfriend. Do I need to listen to these sermons and these presentations? The answer is yes. I can see that many of you, or almost all of you, are into school. Either you want to become a doctor or a nurse. Some of you are even within your 19s, but you are studying to become a doctor. That's going to be your lifetime profession, right? Now, when you get married, it's going to also be your lifetime experience. So the number of years we spent at school in learning to become an engineer, I believe we should spend more years into marriage rather than just to learn it within just 2 weeks for your marriage. Then you go through 2 months counseling, then you're ready for marriage. No, that is why this year we didn't take just one single week, because we cannot even exhaust all these apps and the knowledge about marriage in 1 week. Even this month is even not enough. I believe that we will still put down some programs in the course of the year to educate you. My goal is that all of you, those who are single and those who are even married here, your marriage will be the dream marriage that you want. So after investing more time into this, I hope in the next future, in the next 3 or 4 years, I'll be getting more invites to come to conduct more weddings and engagement. Don't forget to invite me though, ladies and the guys, don't forget to invite me. Yes. All right, so this evening at 7, that's when we're going to have our dinner. Okay, that's where we're going to have our dinner. And as I said, Mr. and Mrs. Hansen is going to be there with that. Now, for the rest of my time, let's dive into my message. Let's take our Bibles and open to Proverbs chapter 30 from verse 18 to 19. Let's hear the word of God. 3 things are too wonderful for me. 4, I do not understand. Verse 19. An eagle flying in the sky, a snake moving on a rock, a ship finding its way over the sea, and a man and a woman falling in love. Let's bow for a word of prayer. Father Divine, I thank you so much, Lord. I don't have any message, but you do. So within these few minutes, please use me to speak to your children. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Fall in love and stay in love. Now, I want us to do this exercise. I want you to turn to your left and right. Listen to this. Listen to me. I don't know whether the person sitting next to you is in love or is yet to be in love. but you can figure it out and put it in the right context. Tell the person, fall in love and stay in love, or prepare to fall in love and stay in love, depending upon the person's situation. So turn to your left and right and tell the person sitting next to you, fall in love and stay in love. Those that are not in love, just tell them, prepare to fall in love. And when you fall in love, make sure you stay in love. Amen. Amen. Love is a wonderful thing. Love is wonderful. Those of you who are not in it yet, don't worry, you'll get there. And even without you not being in love, at least you have experienced your parents' love. And you see how it is. Now, there is a saying. This quote is very important to me and for my message today, which says, we fall in love by chance, but we stay in love by choice. I hope you guys brought your pen and paper. Today, I did a lot of research, so please take pen and paper and take notes. Very, very important message. In fact, this is one of the most important messages about relationship and marriage that you ever hear from this pulpit. So please take note of it. So, we fall in love by chance, but we stay in love by choice. It's easy to fall in love. Ask those who have fallen in love before. It is so easy. But the issue is that after you have fallen in love, will you be able to stay in love? That has been the burden of many people, young people, and even those who are even already married. How can you fall in love and still stay in love for almost 30 years or 50 years of your life? That is my message. Now, there is this research group called Jetnost Research. They have done a survey about how people break up relationships. Now, according to them, they say it is estimated that 70% of couples break up within the first year of dating. About 70% of people who fall in love, start dating, 70% of them break up in the first year. This is serious. Now, this research continues to say that 60% of couples who break up are likely to get back together. I think that one is the good news, right? Sometimes. Yes, that's what the survey says. So, if you are here and you have experienced broken heart, there's 60% chance of you guys coming back together. Not only that, now pay attention to this. 64% of Americans have gone through a breakup of a long-term relationship. 64% of Americans have gone through breakup. So this is a problem. Why is it that people fall in love, but they can't stay in love? That 64% ends in a breakup. Now, out of this 64%, look at what this survey says. Women are more likely to call it a quit than the men. Did you know that? You know, this is a shock, right? Yes, sometimes we have the notion that men are the ones that usually abandon, break the lady's heart. No. The survey says that women are more likely to call a quit in a relationship during dating more than the men. Guys, won't you say amen? It's a fact, right? God bless you. Now, here's the other part. So this message is about those who are not married and those who are married. So I will take both sides. Now, for those who are yet to get married, those are the statistics that I gave you. Now, those that are married, in fact, many marriages end in divorce. And friends, let me tell you this. Broken hearts hurt. It hurts to experience broken hearts. Ask those who have experienced broken hearts and they are going to tell you. You ask them. Ask them, they are going to tell you. It is not a wonderful experience to be at. It is not a good experience to go through. But listen, divorce is worse. If you think breakup is worse, divorce is worse. In fact, according to a lot of marriage counselors, they are saying divorce is worse than death. Because let's assume somebody died when they send a person to the cemetery and they bury the person. That is it. You don't see the person again, right? But when you get divorced, the painful thing is that if you have children, every time you're going to see this man. Can you imagine somebody you've been in marriage for a long time, you get divorced, and you see this man when you go to Walmart, you see this person. When you go to Ghana, during a funeral time, you see the same person. It's worse than death. So for the rest of my message, journey with me as we go through the scriptures to see how we can fall in love and also stay in love. Say amen. Now, let me take you quickly back to my scripture reading. I quoted from Proverbs chapter 30, verse 18 to 90. Friends, I was not quoting from my own words, by the way. I was reading from the Bible, and this is what it says. There are three things. Now, let me give you the context of this. This statement came from the wisest person ever lived. I hope you guys know him. Who is that? It's not Elon Musk. Who said Elon Musk? Oh, man. Solomon. Listen to what Solomon said. Solomon said, there are three things that are too wonderful for me. Four of them, me, Solomon, I don't even understand. Literally, this is what Solomon is saying. Four of them, I don't understand. What are these four things that Solomon is saying? He can't comprehend. He doesn't understand. The first one, he says, an eagle in the sky. Solomon said when he looks at how far an eagle can go in the sky, he thinks and sometimes he cannot understand. In fact, time will not allow me to go through eagle and how they fly. Now, the second one, he said, a snake on a rock. Do you know that snakes do not have legs, but they can be on the rocks that they will not fall down? So if you haven't taken time to study snakes, take time. So Solomon looked at all these and said, see this snake? They don't have any legs, but they're able to walk through rocks without falling. This doesn't make sense to me. And he continued to say, a ship on a sea. How many of you have been on a cruise before? If not, make sure you go to cruise, okay? Man, it's a wonderful experience. The guys that are married and you haven't gone yet, Dr. Mokla, make sure you take your wife to cruise. By the way, the reason why I'm saying take your wife is because I have taken my wife to Bahamas. Oh, yes. I'm standing in front of God, so I will not lie. It's true. We went to Bahamas. So you haven't experienced that. Please go. Solomon is saying that for this big ship on the screen to be in the center of an ocean without sinking, I don't understand. This is very heavy, but it's able to float. Now, Solomon said, let me reserve the best for the last. Solomon said, with this, it doesn't make sense to me. For a man to fall in love with a woman, I don't understand. You guys will not understand. You see this picture? This boy, he was born and raised in Kumasi. Atonsu, Kumasi, that area. Grew up over there. And you see the lady? This lady was born in Accra, raised in different culture. And one day, these two people from these two different backgrounds met and they said, we are in love. Solomon said, this doesn't make sense. It's okay, Eric, you're good. Do you understand what Solomon is saying? Have you ever take time to ponder how people fall in love? Dr. Mokla, in a different part of the region, this and Omi, different parts. They met and they look at each other. They can't stop looking at each other. Then finally, Dr. Mokla proposed. And she accepts. Solomon said, it doesn't make sense to me. I don't understand. He said, there are four things. A man falling in love, I don't understand. Friends, love and falling in love is a powerful thing that sometimes we take it for granted. Now, pay attention to this quote. This quote is very important. Please take note of this. Listen, the feeling of love is such a powerful emotion that to sustain it, people are willing to sacrifice almost anything. Their marriage, their children's happiness, their career, and even their faith. You didn't get it. Let me read it again. Listen, the feeling of being in love, is such a powerful emotion that to sustain that feeling of being in love, people are willing to sacrifice almost everything to fall in love. Have you seen a young guy or a lady who is in love with a guy and the parents are saying, hey, we don't want you to marry this guy because of, and the lady say, I am not going to listen to you. If you're going to abandon me, I will still go ahead and marry this person. People are willing to sacrifice even their entire family to be in love. Now, let me also tell you this. Those that are married, when people fall out of love in marriage and they get that love somewhere, they are married at first, they were in love, but for some reason, the person fell out of love. Now, when they got into another love outside their marriage, I want to tell you that those people are also willing to sacrifice their marriage. They don't care what the church says. They are willing to sacrifice their children's happiness. They will tell you, if I will get somebody to love me and my children are going to suffer as a result of divorce, I will still go ahead. That is how powerful love is. Not only that, their career. People can even sacrifice their career just to be in love with a lady. Not only that, their faith. Have you seen a Christian turn into a Muslim just to marry a Muslim lady? That is how powerful the feeling of being in love is. Friends, this is something we got to study and understand. To fall in love is easy, but to stay in love is something that each and every one of us here and those who are listening to me needs to understand and work towards it till the end. In fact, of late, I hear some divorce among our own Ghanaian young couples that are getting divorced at a faster rate. So, friends, you need to know how to stay in love. You know, you see this couple? These two young guys, these two people, be in love. It's not just by an accident. It's not because they were meant to be. That is why Patience and Pastor Samuel are still in love. But rather, they made a conscious decision. We made a conscious decision to stay in love. Are you listening to me? We fell in love, but to stay in love up to this time and still love her, it must be a conscious decision the two of you must make, or else you fall out of love. So for the rest of my message, we're going to see, I know it's easy to get in love, but to stay in love. Now, the obvious question is, what is love? What is love? You know, when you read the Bible from 1 John chapter 4, verse 6, it says, and we have known and believed the love that God has for us. God is love. And he who abides in love abides in God, and God in him. Amen. Love originates from God. That is why my first message, I told you, marriage and relationship are for Christians. Because love originates from God. In fact, when you continue to read the Bible from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, it says, love, giving us more meaning and definition of love. Love suffers long. Love is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself. It is not puffed up, does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, and love is not provoked. This is classical definition of love. Now, let me take you to relationship and marriage. I know some of you are yet to date and some of you are dating. Now, let's get into relationship and marriage. What are the love in marriage? Friends, I want to tell you that there are two kinds of love in marriage or relationship, whether you are courting or when you are dating. There are two types of love that you need to know, these two loves, two types, and understand. The first one is known as the romantic love. Everybody say romantic love. Romantic love, it is the feeling of being in love. Feeling, finding someone irresistible. Have you ever been in that experience? Man, you can't wait to talk to that person all the time. You know, Dr. Mokla will say, oh, Naomi, let me go and at least, and Dr. Mokla will go, okay, see you. And Sister Naomi will say, okay, Dr. Mokla, let me also go and throw you. The two of you will be going back and forth. Do you last? You can't resist. You always want to be. That is romantic love. But stay with me. Stay with me. Now, it goes deeper with romantic love. With romantic love, guys, understand this. It is an emotion that your brain creates whenever certain conditions are met. You see, I've underlined something. Now, we've seen romantic love. We love romantic love. But romantic love is an emotion that your brain creates whenever certain conditions are met. In other words, if the conditions are not met, there will not be any romantic love. Now, the question is, what is that conditions? That conditions can be ascertained through the second type kind of love in marriage, which is known as caring love. Everybody say caring love. What is caring love? Caring love, it is a decision to try to do what you can to make someone happy. Let me take my time. When you talk about caring love in marriage and relationship, it is a decision to try to do what you can to make someone happy. In other words, if you are able to make someone happy, it will trigger romantic love. If you show more care, it will translate and generate to romantic love. Now, let me add more to the caring love. Listen to this. Caring love, although it triggers romantic love, caring love cannot always guarantee marital happiness and success. Do you understand this? Let me repeat it again. What I'm saying is that caring love is very important in marriage and relationship. Very, very important. But caring love cannot always guarantee marital happiness and success. Pastor Jay, how? This is the reason. Because your care may not actually trigger your partner's or your spouse's feeling of romantic love towards you. Because your care, you are showing care. Oh, you are buying things for the person. You're doing good things for the person. You are showing your care. You know, some guys care so much. You know, Sammy and, you know the guys, you know, Jeff and those guys. They will show the care. But guess what? Guess what, guys? It's not every care that you show to a lady that can trigger romantic love. In other words, if you don't provide the exact need during that care, it will not lead to romantic love. So sometimes guys will say, oh, I spent so much money on this lady, and she doesn't even look at me. You are not hitting the right spot. Now let me tell you this. When your act of care, are you listening to me? When your act of care meets your partner or your spouse's important emotional needs, they trigger romantic love. Say amen. Do you understand this? Let me take my time here. Yes, you are showing care. Yes, you are doing a lot of things, but it's not every need. If you are able to provide or care for the person and meet their important, the word that I have underlined is important emotional needs. If you are able to provide that important emotional need, friends, I want to tell you that with all confidence that it's going to trigger romantic love. That is why, Dr. Mokla, you fell in love with her. You provided the exact need that led to romantic love. Now, let me tell you this. In the end, it's romantic love that keeps your marriage secure, not caring love. Take your time. Think about this again. I'm talking about two types of love in marriage, romantic love and caring love. Caring love brings romantic love. But I want to tell you that for you to have a secure marriage, it depends on the romantic love. That is why you see people that are married, because they are not having the romantic love in their marriage, they are always looking out somewhere. So unless you understand this, what will lead to romantic love and maintain romantic love in your relationship and in your marriage is not secure. Caring love has a role. It is very important. But it is romantic love that secures marriage. Now, with this in mind, there is this doctor called Dr. Wohard Halley. He came out with a principle called Love Bank. Everybody say Love Bank. So with him, he is trying to help us stay in love. If we know that for us to have a secure marriage, it must depend on romantic love, emotional needs, then this is what he says. He says, every one of us here has a love bank. We all have a love bank. Things that makes you fall in love for somebody. Now, you know, when you have like the regular daily banks, like Fifth Third Bank, Chase Bank, we have all these banks. We go, we deposit money. In other words, we put our money there, then we withdraw our withdrawals. We do withdrawals. We take some things out. Now, in our love bank, to maintain and stay in love, you must always deposit in your love bank. Now, what do I mean by deposit in love bank? That is the good experience that you have. So, in any kind of relationship that you may find yourself, if you experience good things, if you have a good experience, you are depositing into your love bank. And if you experience, you have bad experience, you are withdrawing from your love bank. So what you do, direct or indirect, affect your partner's love bank. That is why some people cannot stay in love, because you've been withdrawing from their love bank, and now they've gone overdraft. There is nothing in the account. Before any marriage will get to that point, although they were in love at first, but the other partner has given him or her a bad experience upon bad experience to the extent that all the love is out. The account is empty. But to stay in love, you must give that person good experience. The more you give, the more your account becomes higher and grows. Friends, let me tell you this. When someone's balance in our love bank is high, pay attention here. Those of you who are single, those of you who are in relationship, pay attention, and even those who are married. If someone's balance in our love bank is high, we are attracted to that person. Do you understand it? When someone's balance in your love bank is high, you are always attracted to that person because the person gives you good experience that creates the love. When the account is very high, the feeling of romantic love is triggered. Are you listening? Anytime the account, your love bank account is very high, it always triggers romantic love. But when someone has a negative balance, we find that person unattractive or even repulsive. Now, the next question that maybe some of you are saying, Pastor Samuel, what if I fall in love, how can I stay in love? Or how can I deposit more in my love account? In the person that I'm so interested in, how can I deposit more love into her or his account? Friends, take note of this. Everything you do Everything. If you're in a relationship, if you're in a marriage, everything you do affects your partner or your spouse. It affects their love account. Whatever you do in your life, with your experience, conversation, everything that you do, it affects their love account. It's either making love bank account deposits or withdrawals. Whatever you do, with that relationship that you have with that person, in your own marriage, whatever you do in that marriage, is either you are depositing or you are taking, you taking things out. Because of that, we need to be very careful of our behavior. Because if everything that I do in the house, if everything that I do in that relationship contribute to my love account with the person, that means every single behavior I need to be very careful of. Now, with behavior, we can group our behavior into two main ways. We have what is known as instincts and habits. Instincts is a behavioral patterns that do not seem to be learned. Instincts are some things that you don't learn, that you literally just do it. You know, kids, nobody teach them how to take their mom's breast milk. If you have a baby, you can see the moment the baby comes, just put the baby on top of the mother, the baby will literally move up and get to the milk. Yes, they don't need to be told. So we all have some instinct behavior that we need to be very careful of. But the most important of it is our habits. What are habits? Habits are behavioral patterns that become automatic and almost effortless when we repeat often enough. They are behaviors that we repeat often. The more you do that particular thing, the more you become used to it, to the extent that you do without thinking. Like when you wake up in the morning, some of you don't need to think how you take shower. Because whilst you are in the shower, you are even thinking about what you're going to do. You don't even know, but you are taking shower, you are doing all what you have to do. Because it has become a habit. You have done it over and over. That is something that just you can do it without thinking. This is very crucial in our love bank, our habits. Because habits multiply love bank deposits and withdrawals. Your habits, whatever you do, that you do without thinking repeatedly, it either multiplies your love bank deposits or your withdrawals. Now, if our habits are very crucial, that means we need to be very careful of what we do, because our behavior and our reaction affect the other person's love account. Now, if that is the case, from what I defined from the beginning, in every marriage, we need two types of love. That is romantic love and caring love. To nurture and grow that love, you must understand that emotional need that will trigger the romantic love. So what is the emotional need of men and women? That if we are able to provide that exact need, it will trigger the love and romantic relationship in that person. Now, emotional needs is a craving that, when satisfied, makes us feel happy and feel and fulfilled. And when unsatisfied, makes us feel unhappy and frustrated. Do you understand this? I'm talking about emotional needs because this is very important. Guys, you need to understand it. The emotional need of the person that you are in relationship with. You cannot underestimate the emotional needs of a man or a woman. And if you don't identify that emotional need, you may be doing something, you may be showing some caring, but you are wasting your time. What is it? It is a craving, something that makes a person feels happy and fulfilled. And if that person don't get that happiness and fulfillment, they become frustrated and unhappy. So if you are able to provide things that will make your partner or your spouse happy all the time, you are depositing in his or her love account. For the rest of my message, my time is almost up. Time will not allow me. So I'll just give you five most important emotional needs of men. Ladies, take note of this. whether you are single or married, take note of this five. After the men, I will talk about five emotional needs of women, then I'll end my message today. These are the five most, there are a lot of emotional needs of men that trigger their relationship. Let's assume you are in a relationship, you are hoping that this guy is so good, kind, he is the kind of guy that I want. How can I maintain? There is a connection now with me and him. How can I maintain that love till we get to the altar? Friends, you need to know and understand these emotional needs and provide this need as much as you can. That will lead you into the altar and help you to stay in marriage. In fact, this list, they are not in order of importance, as I have just mixed them. Now, the first one is recreational companionship. With men, I'm talking about the emotional needs of men. These are very important to men. It is something that makes them happy. What is the recreational companionship? Let's assume your partner or your husband loves soccer. They will be very happy if you support them in their kind of recreation that they are interested. If they love soccer, even if you don't like, pretend and be with that person. Be a cheerleader. If they love sports, don't kill. I don't like sports. I don't like soccer. I like basketball. It shouldn't be a conflict. If that is what the man likes, be a companion. Don't be against what he likes. Are you understanding the point I'm just trying to make? You know, there are so many of us that when we are in relationship, we want to change some behaviors. Yes, there are some behaviors that we can change. But in terms of recreational activities, if you want to maintain the love and stay in love, make sure you become a companion in their recreation. Men love sports. Make sure you love it too. Try and develop the love. Whatever sports that the person is, and whatever activity that they are interested, time will not allow me, I will not spend my time. The second one is physical attractiveness. Men want their women to look good. Are you listening to me? You know, let me talk about those who are married. There are some people that when they got married, they start dressing. They dress anyhow because I like the anyhow you added. Because they think that I have arrived. You are doing withdrawals from his love bank. You must make sure that you are always attractive to the man. When you are in relationship, when you are not married yet, don't say that now that I am secured, I have this guy, I'm going out with, the church is away. So, man, ladies, man, you need to work out. I am gone. Because of that, you're going to dress anyhow. You're not going to fix your hair, look good. Be careful the man doesn't fall out of love. Physical attractiveness is a man's emotional need. They want to see. You know, men like to watch, right? Ladies, you know that? Yeah, men, we want to watch. We want to look. You see? That is what. So, you have to always look attractive. Whether you've been married for 30 years, 50 years, whether you are dating or you are in courtship, make sure you always, anytime you go to the person, you put on the best that you can. It is very important. The second one is domestic support. Now, let me be candid with some of the ladies. Men have this emotional need. We want this domestic support. Listen, the word underline is support. Preparing food for your man. It's men's emotional need. Men don't joke with food. They expect that need to be fulfilled. I know some of you, why can't he cook? Why can't he cook? If you take that mindset, listen to me, ladies. If you think, yeah, we all work, so why can't he? If you take that mindset, you will fall in love, but you may not stay in love. It is emotional need of men. The top five, domestic support. Cooking is support. I'm not saying just provide all of it for them. You cook, they can help, but they expect you to support them in house duties, cooking, house chores, and those things. It is a need of men. You can, those of you who are married, just imagine when your wife-to-be used to come to your house to prepare food for you, you know, like, It is emotional need. Very important. Take note of that. Third one, fourth one. Admiration. Admiration. Do you know what attracted you to your partner or your spouse? Maybe one day you guys met at church and said, hey, Jeff, man, I like your suit. That day, you killed Jeff. You killed Jeff. And somebody has recognized the effort, you know. Man, we put in effort, oh, guys. Ladies, when we dress, so make sure you give it to us because, you know, we took some time. You ask Jeff. So what I'm just trying to say is that words of admiration, what you say, praise the person. Man, we need it. We want to be pumped. Like, you are doing well. I like the way you pray. I like the way you teach. I like the way you do Sabbath school. I like the way you dress. Man, I we want to hear that. It's an emotional need. We want that. Listen to me. Some of you have the mindset that if I say that, his head will be pumped. So I'm not going to tell him, for him to feel like he's so handsome. I'm not going to say it. You know, some ladies have that mindset. If you tell the guy he's handsome, he's going to feel like he's... You don't say it. Mimi say, you won't say it. You better say it. So what I'm saying, admiration is very important. Your words. Friends, I'm talking about emotional need. The things that will trigger romantic love is what I'm talking about. If you start commenting about his dressing, the way he cooks, the way he cleans, if you keep doing that, it's going to trigger the romantic love. Some of you, when I made mention of emotional, you think I was just going to talk about sex. No. No. These are some of the things that men need. And if you're able to provide, it will lead you to the altar and you will stay in marriage. Fourth one. You think I won't say this one, right? It's very important. It's very, very, very important. Especially when you are married. Not even especially. No. When you are married, that is when it's very important. But before marriage, no. That one is not part. That one, don't provide. Don't. Sexual fulfillment is emotional needs of men for married couples. So make sure when you are married, you provide that needs. If you do that, it is going to trigger the romantic love. Now, what about the women? I know the men can't wait. Let me do it quick and end my message. So these are the five important emotional needs of women. In fact, this wasn't just came up by myself. This is a research that prominent and gurus of marriage relationship have come together to provide. Now, the first one is affection. Men, listen, if you want to deposit more into their love bank account, you must show affection. You know, we have this mentality that, I'm not romantic, Pastor. You keep on with, I'm not romantic. Before you realize, somebody, one guy in the church, this stubborn guy will come and show the lady romance, and before you realize, it's gone. And you're going to say, women love the voice. Do you hear what I'm saying? Guys, listen to me. Learn to be romantic. If you are not, tell them you love them. Some of you feel so... I know this generation, we are different. But those people over there, that watch them go, No. But I know our generation, we are different. We must show affection. Tell your wife, tell your partner, test him, test her. Show that. Don't hide that emotion. If you do that, it helps the ladies. It builds, you are depositing in their love account. And it triggers their romantic love, which will sustain and lead to the altar. Guys, take note of this. The second one. Conversation. Do you guys know that women love to talk? I know guys, we don't. In fact, I didn't get time to do the research. The number of words, the average number of words women say in a day. But make time for them. Don't say, she talks too much. No, relax. Some of us, I know we are not good listeners, but we must learn, Dr. Mokla. We must. We must pay attention and look at them. Those who are dating. In relationship, make sure you get time for conversation. Women want to talk. That's how God created them. Let them talk. Listen. Listen. And when they say sometimes, you don't even need to say anything. Just let them talk. But don't say, are you done? Don't add that one. Don't say that one. conversation. Listen to this, is very important too. This means spending time with them. America is so stressful. Yes. Mrs. Hansen, am I right? It's so stressful. School, man. So when she comes home, please put the work aside. Listen to her. Maybe she has listened to a lot of instructions. She needs to pour it on you. Very, very important. Get time for that. The third one, honesty and openness. Guys, listen. Women love honesty. If you are so honest and open to them, if they fall in love with you and you are so open, like you don't hide anything. You know, we have these people that privacy, privacy, you can't take my phone, you can't take... Friends, let me tell you this. When your relationship is different, but when you get married, there's nothing like privacy. There's nothing like privacy. I need to have my time. No. There must be fairness and openness and honesty. That will be the foundation of the marriage. I know some marriage counselors will say, oh, don't touch his phone. Don't touch her phone. Before marriage, you can do that. But when you get married, there's no secret. I can look through your phone. You can look through my phone. So if there's something there, make sure you open up. Open up before it's too late. Very, very important. Listen, guys, what I'm saying is that, ladies, if you really want to be in love and stay in love and take that lady to the altar, the lady is waiting to see if you are an honest person. Now, if you are so vulnerable and you open up to the person, they will love you more. You are depositing into their love account. Fourth point, financial support. Financial support. Ladies, financial support. You know, they say, Odoka crazy, kaka cry, right? Man, let me tell you, ladies want security. They do. Even those are in the church, they want to make sure that you can take care of them. So they care about the money you have. They do. Your work, your profession. I'm not saying it should be the number one point, but they care. In case you don't know, it's emotional need of women. If you can't provide for them, and somebody can provide for them, this will trigger romantic love. Ladies, am I lying? Thank you. I'm not lying. God bless you. You, God bless you. Anyway, what I'm saying is a need for women. This doesn't mean that you should have like a lot of money. You know, these women are understanding because they come from a very good home. They know how their parents struggle with money. So they are not expecting you to have the whole bank. But at least there should be something. If you're able to provide their needs, it triggers their romantic love. Fifth point, commitment. Commitment. Guys, ladies, this is one of the most important needs of women. They want commitment. If your dating has gotten to the pre-engagement stage, they want to see commitment. You can't still be talking to guys in the church. You can't do that. They want commitment. They want to see that they are special. Before marriage, yes, you are almost there. If it's in the early stages, it's different. But when you guys are getting serious, please, they need commitment. They want to see that you are proud of them. You know, initial stage, they will hide it from the pastor, they will hide it from Dr. Mokla. But when they get to some point, no, you should be bold that, yes, this is going to be my man. This is going to be my lady. If you do that, oh, you are depositing in their love account. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Time's up. I'll end here. But I'll end with this. Take note. I made mention of this quote. When your acts of care meet your partner's or your spouse's important emotional needs, they do what? Trigger their romantic love. And my last word is this. And in the end, it's romantic love that keeps your marriage secure. God bless you.
Amen. What is the plan for us? To fall in love and
stay in love.
Stay in love. The goal is marriage and to continue on. So we want to say a big amen to our lovely pastor for that word. Amen. Amen. May God bless you. So we are coming to a close, and I would like to invite our praise team to come and sing us the closing hymn 458, and then our pastor will give us the benediction.
If we may all rise as we sing our closing hymn, 'Tis Love That Makes Us Happy.
Hello.
Called above, our song shall be eternally of Jesus and his love. God is love, we are his little children. God is love, we'll be like him. It is love that smooths the way, it up us mind, it makes us kind to others every day.
God is love.
pray, let's pay attention to these few announcements. Right from here, we'll go to the fellowship hall. We have something small for us. Since we're preparing for the dinner, we don't want to spend much time here. So right after the fellowship hall, let's go get ready. Let's go get ready for the dinner this evening. If you need the address, let us know. We'll give you the address. No lateness. It's 7 p.m. We have a limited time. Listen, guys, we have a limited time to be there, and we have a lot of events. So let's be there by 7 so that we can spend that, I think, either 4 hours over there. We can spend that hour as well. So let's be there on time. All right. Let's bow for a word of prayer. Father Divine, we thank you so much this wonderful Sabbath. We thank you for reminding us and preparing us for what is ahead of us. We believe that marriage started in Garden of Eden, and we took it out of Eden. And your word says if we keep marriage right, it will be like a little heaven on earth for us. Because of that, we want to start learning. Because of that, we want to know what is in it before we get into it. So, Lord, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that this month, let it be a new experience for all of us here, those that are not married and those that are married. We know this week is not the last part. Next week, I know you're going to give us a message. After all this knowledge, how do we make the decision? How do we know if he or she is the right person? So, Lord, prepare those speakers that will be leading us next week as well. Father, I also want to commit anybody here that is or that was once upon a time in love but is no longer in love anymore. If there's a way in which the Lord can restore the love and so that they can stay in love, Lord, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that you help that person. Whether they are in a relationship preparing towards marriage or whether they are even in marriage and they are not even in love, I believe that today is going to be a blessing for us. So, Lord, pour your blessings upon all of us. If anybody came this place to your sanctuary here with a problem and that person has been praying and worrying and seeking for help, Lord, I pray because the person is in your presence. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that you, Lord, will take that burdens from them and give them peace of mind in their life, their career, and everything that they get themselves involved with. We thank you so much for blessing us. For I commit the food that we're going to eat into your hand, that you, Lord, will bless and sanctify the food for us as well. This is a humble prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus have I prayed. Amen.
Say, oh, what's it all? Oh, Just the sum of every high and every low.